There's a chair in my kitchen, and it's driving me insane. Part 2/final by Num 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 Nation, aka Ben Wooding. I'm sitting in the chair as I write this. The chair still had 2 legs this morning. I've counted 15 times since my last post. It feels harder to count them each time I do. I couldn't wrap my head around how this chair continued to stand. It broke everything I knew. Sometimes I would count the back leg first, sometimes I would count the front leg first. It did not change anything. 2 is always the final leg. I didn't sleep last night. I just stared at the chair. I could feel it staring back at me. I tried not to count the legs too often. Earlier today, a police officer knocked on my door. I didn't get her name while she was alive. She showed me a picture of Jason and his colleague and asked if I knew anything about their disappearances. I don't know if it was my pale face from living a nightmare or my bloodshot eyes from lack of sleep, but she didn't buy my no. She came in pushing past me and went into the kitchen. I'd cleaned up the blood and guts, but it still smells terrible. She took one look at the chair and looked at me. She could sense something off about the chair, too. I knew I would sound crazy if I told her everything, and I'd get blamed for everything that's happened. That's the chair with 2 legs. I spoke calmly, while just inside, I felt anything but. She did not take this as the warning I hoped it would convey, and she immediately pushed the chair to see if it would fall over. She screamed as her hand seemed to shrink, and as this effect worked its way up her arm like someone squeezing a tube of toothpaste. She reached for her gun instinctively, using the hand that had just disappeared. Somehow, though, it worked. The gun seemingly floated in the air as she held it. She stared at it for a moment, but only a moment. The gun disappeared and her arm continued to vanish. Soon it wasn't everything vanishing. Only her skin. Blood poured out. This is the second time I've seen it happen. The second time I've seen the chair consume someone as if they were nothing. I felt myself trembling. I wondered if the chair was alive, if it could think for itself. Does it enjoy what it does? I counted the legs to distract myself. 1, 2. I counted backwards. It didn't change anything. 2, 1. Then, again, it happened. For a brief moment around the time her heart hit the floor, the chair had 3 legs. Then the chair was gone. She was too. The blood, the organs, everything. It was as if the chair had cleaned up after itself. I thought it was over. It was not. I reached for a spoon and threw it at where the chair used to be. It froze there, mid-air. A loud bang came from my bedroom as the spoon fell. I slowly made my way into the bedroom. I creaked the door open, and there it was. The chair, 2 legs, both at the front now. I counted out loud just to be sure. 1, 2. Speaking out loud did not change the outcome. I had hoped it would. I still had Jason's phone in my pocket. I wanted to use it, but something else came over me instead. I'd had enough. This chair was driving me insane, so I decided I'd do what I thought I would never do. The very thought of sitting upon the chair made me feel dread. The kind of dread you get when there's something you know you have to do, but don't want to. Make no mistake, this is something I had to do. Something told me it was the only way forward. As I sat on it, I did one thing differently from everybody else. I made sure that no part of me was touching the ground as I made contact with the chair. I jumped back into it as I sat. I think this is why the chair chose to spare me. I didn't morph, I didn't contort. But the world around me did. Walls moved, furniture shrunk and grew, holes appeared in the floor and ceiling. It slowed to a stop, and I've been too afraid to get up from this chair since. I don't want to touch this morphed world. I couldn't understand why the chair didn't consume me. I thought at first that it was torturing me, killing people in front of me, yet refusing to put me out of my misery. But I know better now. I noticed, could see through my wall. There's a gaping hole, yet no debris. I could see my neighbor sitting in his dining room. I could see through his skin. I could see inside of him. Yet he continues to sit there as if nothing is wrong. I look down. One, two, three, four. All four legs are here. I sat here in a broken world, yet this chair, it finally makes sense. It finally isn't broken. This chair has four legs. I notice, surrounding me are the bodies of the chair's previous victims. Jason, the police officer, the other agent, the cat. They were scattered around me as if they were never torn apart. But what did that matter? This chair is four legs. There are four. Four legs at last. The phone in my pocket rang. This isn't the first time it's rang. I answer it now with a smile.
Jason, we think we have a lock on the chair. We're coming to get you.
My name isn't Jason, I replied. And the chair has four legs. I hung up. A few minutes later, four agents show up. I could see them through the walls before they even entered. They made their way into my bedroom and seemed to pretend they couldn't see me. One of them spoke into a radio.
The chair is here, but nobody else is.
He didn't know I could see through his skin.
It has two legs.
Why was he lying? It is four. I can count them all. One, two, three, four. I spoke out loud to see if they would pretend to not hear me. Hello? They all looked around. One spoke into their radio again.
Someone is here, but they're not in our cross-section of the fourth dimension. They've rotated through it.
I don't know how they survived. He didn't touch the chair, but I did reach out to him as he got closer. I wanted to see what would happen. I wanted to see if he would stop pretending he couldn't see me. He started screaming. I'm not sure why. He looked fine. In fact, his skin was back. He fell backwards, knocking into all of his colleagues. They all got their skin back. They were all screaming. Then they all dropped to the ground. I think they're dead. But the chair has four legs. Everything should be fine. I don't know why these agents were so interested in such a normal chair. They should be more concerned about the rest of the world. Everything is broken. I'm not sure what these agents want or where they're coming from. I'm still trying to figure out what the agents meant when they spoke about dimensions. They're probably going to send more agents out soon. I wonder if they'll pretend not to see me too. my chair has four legs. And it's keeping me sane.
Hey y'all, Ninja Gamer, and thank you so much for watching today's video. If you did enjoy, please feel free to leave a like on the videos. It does help the channel innumerably and does get the gospel on people's feeds, as well as please consider subscribing as we are trying to hit 10,000 subs by the end of the year. And it would be a massive blessing for the Lord if you guys did so. Of course, if you guys haven't done so already, if we hit 10,000 subs by the end of the year, I will be platinuming one of the hardest games known to man, Crypt of the Necrodancer. So get us to that amazing number so that we will be able to plat that insanely difficult game. I know we can do it. So praise the Lord for that. If you guys haven't done so already, make sure to, on screen right now is the $1 million question. Please give it a read. It will also be in the pinned comment or description if you prefer to read it that way. But please do give it a read, as it will teach you how to gain eternal life, how to go to heaven. Who wouldn't want that? It'll teach you about repenting of your sins and trusting in the good Lord Jesus Christ with our own mental strength, as well as building that relationship with the Lord by reading the Holy Bible daily, praying daily, and evangelizing people. It is great stuff, so please, please, please do so. As always, guys, $1 million question, as well as anything else I talk about here at the end of these videos, is not associated with the, author of the story in any way, shape, or form, unless otherwise mentioned. It is for you, the viewer, to read. So please do so. Of course, the amazing Nom 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 Nation, aka Ben Wooding, a link to his Reddit page, as well as the original story link, will be found in the description, as well as let me know what you thought of the story. This man's like trapped in the dimensional plane. It's very interesting. Very interessant, if you will. So let me know what you guys thought of that. Thought of the story in general. Very cool little series as well. Of course, guys, if you, the amazing Mew, whose music I use in all of these videos, a link to his YouTube channel as well as all the music will be found in the description. If you'd like to use his music for your videos, make sure that the specific song that you would like to use, it'll say one of two things. It'll say it's either free to use as long as credit is given, or it'll say it is not free to use as long as credit is given. So if it says it's not free to use as long as credit is given, obviously you can't use it, but if it says it is free to use as long as credit is given, you are easily able to pop a beautiful link to his YouTube channel in your description, and you will easily as well as possibly the music, the link to the music as well, itself. I more do that so that if you guys would like to listen to his music in your free time, like I love to do, I did earlier today, listen to Moonlight Mention, which is one I don't use for these videos, but it is an amazing one. You're able to, instead of scrounging the internet for eons, you know? So, yeah. Of course, my brothers have a YouTube channel, Tamak Plush Videos, where they're uploading plush videos, and they're uploading daily in 2024. I believe so, anyways. And, I make quite a few cameos over there, so if you want to see me in something other than horror stories and video games, go check it out, it's great stuff. Highly recommend the 2021 videos, as well as the amazing South Park series, which has been a recent series that has come up. And I have a theory cabinet in it, so come on over, folks, it's great time, and I'd love to see you over there. Be amazing. Of course, my youngest brother Cole wants to be a rapper, so I'm leaving a link to his YouTube channel in a SoundCloud for his music. The Cole is his name. It's great stuff. So please, 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 please come on over. It's great stuff. And I would love to see you over there. As always, guys, the Barron County Anthology by Random Appalachian 468, as well as a former stalker texted me this morning. She's Been Dead for a Year by Tier 1000. Both beautiful, amazing playlists will be found in the description for you guys to listen to. Some of my favorite stories I've ever done here on the channel. It's really great stuff. Of course, if you guys would like to, if you guys have yet to do so and want more from the Children of the Oakwalker series, the Barron County Anthology is everything before that, and it as well, the Children of the Oakwalker. So if you have yet to catch up, be sure to do so. You'll learn a lot more about a lot of our awesome characters and their origins and how they've kind of come to be in Barron County at the full front of everything going on. So it's pretty important for you to do so. So I would highly recommend doing so, and I would very much appreciate it, of course. As well as if you guys would like to read ahead in the Children of the Oakwalker, a link to Random Appalachian 468's Reddit page will be found in the description. So if you guys would like to read ahead instead of waiting for me to get them out, you are able to do so. Of course, I will be getting them out, so you don't have to be concerned about that, obviously. It's going to take some time, but, it won't be two-month hiatus. I'm sorry it's been over a week since the last part, but it will be coming out soon. But yeah, of course, I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. And yeah, I think I'm going to end it here. Won't ramble on for a long time. Great story, though. You know what I'm saying? The chair has four legs now. It's great. Right? Very interesting. And if you want to know more about the chair, I guess, one of our latest stories that I've done, what is it called? They exist beyond perception. That one talks about the chairs. And kind of where it's come into existence, I guess? I don't know. But I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to y'all later. Maybe stay tuned for a stream tonight. I'd like to do one. I really would. I've been really, really wanting to play PlayStation for so long. And we probably, the game we choose that I will be streaming, if I do stream tonight, should be Manette. Very cool game. And yeah, I will, see that, or I will see y'all later, I suppose. Thanks for the support, as always, guys. You guys have been crazy recently with the support. Now, words cannot describe how much it means to me, truly. It means so, so much. And so thank you, guys, and thank you, Lord, for that. We're doing awesome. We're doing so, so well. You know, we're averaging about 100 views per video now, which is really crazy. And a lot of them. So I really do appreciate that. I don't know if I talked about it yesterday, but I got a really good deal on Armored Core 2. Found it at a Rio store, a Goodwill. I got it for $5, and it normally goes for like 30, which is crazy. That whole series of games goes for so much money. It's insane. Excuse me. So if you can get some good deals on that, be sure to do so. There's also some Spider-Man games that are go for quite a lot. So pick them up for your collections for sure, if that's something you're interested in. I know Armored Core 6 dropped a couple of months back. I had a buddy of mine that was really looking forward to that. So hopefully he played it. I haven't got a chance to ask him about it, but yeah. Great stuff. So yeah. But I do love you guys. Thank you guys so much. And hopefully I see you in the stream if we do stream tonight. I love you guys. Been working on Pokey Clicker in the background, of course. But I've been doing that for freaking weeks now. So, yeah. But I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. And until next time, guys, this is Ninja Gamer. Signing off.